Hello students, we will continue with the chapter trigonometrical ratios of standard angles. In the last class we learnt about the values for each angle, and in this class we will learn how to solve a trigonometrical equation. So to begin with solving a trigonometrical equation, so I am taking few sums from exercise 23C. The first one, 2 sin A is equal to 1. This is a trigonometrical equation. Now transposing 2 to the right hand side, you get sin A is equal to half. Okay. You know for which angle the value of sin is half. It is sin A is equal to sin 30. So A is equal to 30. You are not supposed to cancel sign because it is a ratio and that is not allowed while solving the equation of trigonometry. So you just write A is equal to 30. Now moving on to the next one, 2 cos 2A is equal to 1. Here cos 2A is equal to 1 by 2. You are transposing 2 to the right hand side. Now you know the value of cos for which it is half. It is cos 60 because cos 60 is half. Now 2a is equal to 60. A will be equal to 30 degree. Now the next sum, root 3 tan a is equal to 1. We will follow the same method. You transpose root 3 to the right hand side, you get 1 by root 3. And you know the value of tan for which it is 1 by root 3 is tan 30. So A is equal to 30 degree. Please remember, don't cancel that tan. That is a wrong usage. Now next, root 3 cot 2a is equal to 1. So cot 2a is equal to 1 upon root 3. For which angle the cot is 1 by root 3? It is cot 2a is equal to cot 60. So 2a is equal to 60 degree and A will be equal to 30 degree. Now moving on to the next type of equation. Sin A minus 1, 2 cos A minus 1 equal to 0. So here you will get two equations. The first one is sin A minus 1 equal to 0. The next one is 2 cos A minus 1 equal to 0. So because here both are equal to 0, we will solve the first one. Sin A is equal to 1, transposing minus 1 to the right hand side. You know sin 90 is equal to 1. So A will be equal to 90 degree. Now the second equation, 2 cos A. Now transposing minus 1 to the right hand side, you get equal to 1. So cos A is equal to half. And the angle for which the cos is half, it is cos 60. So A is equal to 60 degree. So here you get two values of A. One is 90 and the other is 60 degree. Now moving on to the next one. Tan A minus 1, cosecant 3A minus 1 equal to 0. Again, here you will get two equation, tan A minus 1 equal to 0, cosecant 3A minus 1 equal to 0. Now, transposing minus 1 to the right hand side, you get tan A is equal to 1. You know the angle for which the tan is 1, it is tan 45. So, A is equal to 45 degree. Next equation, cosecant 3a is equal to 1. Again, you are transposing minus 1 to the right hand side. Cosecant 3a, it is cosecant 90 because cosecant 90 is 1. So 3a is equal to 90 degree. and A is equal to 30 degree. The next one, cos 3A of 2 sin 2A minus 1 equal to 0. Again, you will get two equation. The first one is cos 3A is equal to 0. The next one is 2 sin 2A minus 1 equal to 0. So, cos 3A, for which angle the value is 0? It is cos 90. So, 3A is equal to 90 and A is equal to 30 degree. Remember, don't cancel cos and cos. The next one is 2 sin 2A. Transposing minus 1, you get 1. So, sin 2A is equal to 1 upon 2. It is sin 2A is equal to sin 30. So you get 2A is equal to 30, which will give you A is equal to 15 degree. Next, if 2 sin X minus 1 equal to 0 and X degree is an acute angle, find sin X, X degree, cos X and tan X. So, the expression is 2 sin X minus 1 equal to 0. So, you get 2 sin X is equal to 1. So, sin X is equal to half. So, you got the first answer, that is sin X is equal to half. Now, we will find X degree. Now, sin X is equal to the angle for which the value of sine is half is sine 30. So, X is equal to 30 degree. You got the second one. Now, the third one is cos X. Substituting the value of X here, you got cos 30, which is equal to root 3 by 2. The next one is tan X. Again, you get tan 30. And you know the value of tan 30 is 1 by root 3. Now next, if 4 cos square x minus 1 equal to 0 and the value of x lies between 0 and 90, that is the range for x is 0 to 90, find x degree sin square x plus cos square x. Now, the given expression 4 cos square x minus 1 equal to 0, transposing minus 1 to the right hand side, you get 4 cos square x is equal to 1. So, you get cos square x is equal to 1 by 4 and cos x will be equal to 1 by 4, sorry, root over of 1 by 4, which is equal to half. Now, the angle for which cos is, the value of cos is half is cos 60. So, x is equal to 60 degree. Now, first one you got value of x is 60 degree. Now, we will find the value for this expression, that is sin square x plus cos square x. So, you get sin square 60 plus cos square 60. The value of sin 60 is root 3 by 2. So, root 3 by 2 the whole square plus half square. Cos 60 is half. So, you get 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4, which is equal to 4 by 4. Hence, it is equal to 1. This is one of the identities where it says sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now, the next sum, if sin x plus cos y is equal to 1 and x is equal to 30 degree, find the value of y. Sin x plus cos y is equal to 1. This is the given expression and the value of x is 30. So, substitute the value of x here. Sin 30 plus cos y is equal to 1. You know the value of sin 30, which is equal to 1 by 2. Plus cos y is equal to 1. So, cos y is equal to 1 minus half. 1 minus half is half. And the angle for which cos is half, it is cos 60. So y is equal to 60 degree. So you got the value of y. Now the next one, if 3 tan A minus 5 cos B is equal to root 3 and B is equal to 90 degree, find the value of A. So the expression is 3 tan A minus 5 cos B is equal to root 3. And you know the angle B is 90 degree minus 5 cos 90. Substitute the value of B as 90. So you get 3 tan A minus 5 into 0 because cos 90 is 0, and here you get 3 tan A minus 0. 5 zeros are 0, 3, and tan A is equal to root 3 upon 3. Now you can rationalize it, and therefore this is 3 upon 3 root 3. 3 and 3 gets cancelled. So tan A is equal to 1 upon root 3. So the angle for which tan is 1 by root 3 is tan 30. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3 and A is equal to 30 degree. Now the next sum, find the magnitude of angle A if tan A minus 2 cos A, tan A plus 2 cos A minus 1 equal to 0. Here you can apply the method of factorization, that is by grouping or by splitting the middle term. Any method, wherever it is, whichever way it is possible, you can do it. Now in this case, I am grouping the first two one and the last two one, I have grouped it together. Now if you observe this, in these two, tan A is common. So taking tan A as common, I get 1 minus 2 cos A. And here I will take minus 1, so I get 1 minus 2 cos A is equal to 0. Now 1 minus 2 cos A is common for both. If you observe here, 1 minus 2 cos A is common, and here you get tan A minus 1 equal to 0. So here you get two equation, 1 minus 2 cos A is equal to 0, and the next one is tan A minus 1 equal to 0. Transposing 2 cos A to the right hand side, you get 1 is equal to 2 cos A, or half is equal to cos A. You know the angle for cos, for which it is half, is cos 60 is equal to cos A, or A is equal to 60 degree. In the second equation, you get tan A is equal to 1, transposing 1 to the right hand side, and the angle for which the value of tan is 1 is tan 45. So A is equal to 45 degree. Here you get two values of A. So remember, you are applying the method of factorization here. The next one, find the magnitude of angle A if 2 sin A cos A minus cos A minus 2 sin A plus 1 equal to 0. Applying the same method, you can group the first two and the last two together. So if you observe the first two terms, the common term is cos A. So you get 2 sin A minus 1. Similarly, here you can take minus 1 as common, you get 2 sin A minus 1 equal to 0. Minus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. Now, out of these two terms, 2 sin A minus 1 is common, and you will be left with cos A minus 1 equal to 0. Now you have got two expression, 2 sin A minus 1 equal to 0 and cos A minus 1 equal to 0. Solving this, you get 2 sin A is equal to 1 and sin A is equal to half. And the value for which angle sin angle is half is sin 30. So A is equal to 30. Now the next equation, cos A, transposing minus 1 to the right hand side, you get cos A is equal to 1 and the angle for which the cos is equal to 1 is cos 0 and A is equal to 0. Now the next one, 2 cos square A minus 3 cos A plus 1 is equal to 0. Now here this is of the form of a trinomial. So you can take cos A as x and this becomes 2x square minus 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. So this is a trinomial. Actually this is a quadratic equation because it is equal to 0. Now splitting the middle term, your sum is minus 3 and product is 2. Because the product of first term and the last term. So you get minus 2 minus 1. Split the middle term. It will become minus 2x minus x plus 1 equal to 0. 2x of x minus 1 minus 1 of x minus 1 equal to 0. 2x minus 1 of x minus 1 equal to 0. So you get 2 solutions, 2x minus 1 equal to 0, x minus 1 equal to 0, and 2x is equal to 1 and x is equal to half. In this case you get x is equal to 1, but the value of x is cos A. Substitute the value of x as cos A, so you get cos A is equal to half. In this case you get cos A is equal to 1. And you know the angle for which cos is half is cos 60 degree. So A is equal to 60 degree. And the next one, cos A is equal to cos 0. The value is 0. So A is equal to 0. Now the next sum. If 2 cos 2a is equal to root 3 and a is an acute, find a sin 3a sin 75 minus sin square 75 minus a plus cos square 45 plus a. Now the given expression is 2 cos 2a is equal to root 3. So cos 2a is equal to root 3 by 2. Now cos 2a, you know the angle for which cos is root 3 by 2 is cos 30. So 2a is equal to 30 degree, a is equal to 15 degree. So you get the value of a as 15 degree. Now the next one, sin 3a. Now sin 3a will be sin 3 into 15 degree. The value of a is 15. So you get sin 45, which is equal to 1 upon root 2. The next expression is sin square 75 minus a plus cos square 45 plus a. Substituting the value of a as 15, you get sin square 75 minus 15 plus cos square 45 plus 15. So you get sin square 60 plus cos square 60. Substituting the value of sin 60, which is root 3 by 2 the whole square plus 1 by 2 the whole square, which will give you 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4 is equal to 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. This is also one of the identity. Next, 2 cos 3x minus 1 equal to 0. So you get transpose minus 1 to the right hand side. So you get cos 3x is equal to half. Cos 3x is equal to, the angle for which cos is half is cos 60. So 3x is equal to 60 and x is equal to 20 degree. The next one, cos of x by 3 minus 1 equal to 0. Cos x by 3 is equal to 1. So cos of x by 3 is equal to, is the angle which is giving for cos 1 is cos 0. So x by 3 is equal to 0. X is equal to 0. Cross multiplication. Thank you, children.